Well, the Department of Agriculture says adverse weather is among the reasons for the decline in farm and fisheries production for the third quarter of this year. To tell us more about the government's support for this sector in particular, we have with us on the phone DEA Assistant Secretary and Spokesperson Arnel De Mesa. Magandang umaga po, ASEC. Thank you very much for joining us.
Magandang umaga. Magandang umaga po sa lahat ng nakikinig at nanonood.
Sir, the Department of Agriculture reported almost 4 billion pesos losses in the farm and fisheries sector for the third quarter of 2024, but yet to account for the damage brought about yung mga tropical cyclones that we've experienced in this last quarter. First and foremost, how will that impact po yung food supply ng Pilipinas?
In terms do sa local production, definitely we can expect lower production this year compared to last year. Last year, we saw na very limited yung typhoon na tumama sa bansa natin. This year, aside dun sa mga typhoon, we have El Nino and La Nina. So talagang medyo mabigat yung mga na-experience natin. And for rice sector alone, from January hanggang ngayon kay Typhoon Christine, we already monitored 800,000 metric tons losses. Normally, nasa mga 500,000 metric tons losses every year tayo because of typhoon na 18 to 21 yan. And 4 or 5 typhoon dyan, very destructive. So nalampasan na yung normal average normal natin na losses because of regular typhoons. Ang kagandahan lang, on the import side, we have, as of today, actually, mid-October, we have already registered 3.8 million metric tons of imports sa rice na pumasok. This is already 200,000 metric tons higher from the 3.6 metric tons na pumasok last year. And alam naman natin, because of EO-362, bumaba na yung tarifa. This will help doon sa pagpasok ng volume and of course doon sa pag-stabilize ng prices. So in terms of volume, we still have enough volume that will carry us up to the first quarter of next year. That's our assumptions. So wala tayong problema pagdating sa volume. And yung prices naman, it's na nag-stabilize siya, nagtumataas ng konti, but nag-stabilize naman siya.
As like you mentioned, the prices that medyo tumaas ang konti, I believe you're talking about yung presyo po ng bigas. Are there any other crops or any specific food prices that we could anticipate higher rates dahil sa mga production losses throughout the recent typhoons?
Normally, after typhoons, expected natin nakakaroon ng mga spikes, about 10 to 15%. Tumataas yan depende sa laki ng volume. After Christine, we registered 2,800 metric tons ng reduction ng volume na bumaba sa Metro Manila coming from the Cordilleras, Region 1, Region 2, Central Luzon, and Southern Tagalog. So talagang nagkaroon ng surges sa price. But this is temporary. Normally, about after 2 weeks, nagno-normalize naman siya uli. Pagpasok ng ibang supply coming from other regions, at pag-stabilize din ng supply coming from the affected areas.
For those affected by the typhoon, sir, has the DA provided any kind of assistance to the farmers and fisher folks affected by the calamity?
Yes, of course. As of to date, we have provided 667 million worth of indemnification doon sa mga insured affected farmers by the Philippine Crop Insurance Corporations. We already provided 541 million worth of preposition seeds and fertilizers, as well as the provision of 500 million pesos survival and recovery loan. That's about 25,000 pesos each for affected farmers and fishers. And of course, our 1 billion peso quick response fund for the rehabilitation and recovery of affected areas. And of course, yung deployment natin ng mga kadiwa stores doon sa mga apektado rin na lugar.
ASEC, a lot of the storms coming in right now, medyo nag-intensify. A lot of it has been attributed to climate change in particular, especially after recent studies na mula sa UP. Sir, are the policies in place right now climate change resistant or rather climate change ready with regards to yung mga polisiya trying to address yung farmers po natin, yung mga fisheries?
On the research side, we have already the drought-tolerant varieties and the flood-tolerant varieties ng mga especially sa rice natin and corn. On the policy side, we are adopting initially, dahan-dahan, yung pag-change natin ng cropping calendar. Alam naman natin na yung mga destructive typhoons normally happen during the last quarter of the year. So what we are trying to do is to make it early yung pagtatanim so that we can harvest during the wet season lang naman. Kasi during the dry season, wala tayong masyadong problema except yung availability ng water. But during wet season, we really need to adjust our cropping calendar so we can harvest earlier, say September, maximum October, before dumating yung mga destructive typhoons. Kasi talagang itong huling quarter yung mabibigat at saka mapapinsala ng mga bagyo. So we're already doing that. But of course, we need a lot of adjustments to our farmers and the availability of water during early planting para ma-sustain natin ito. So we are also building up sa guidance ng ating Pangulo at ni Secretary Chu Laurel to carry on yung ating mga big agri-infrastructure projects, especially on irrigation, logistics, and our cold storages.
Maraming salamat. That was DA Assistant Secretary and Spokesperson Arnel De Mesa. Thank you very much for your insight.
Thank you. Good morning.
When we return, thousands of residents are ordered evacuated in California due to a raging wildfire. The details after the break. Keep it here. You're watching BNC, the Bilyonario News Channel.
Ang inyong lingkod si Corina Sanchez Rojas.
Corina Sanchez.
As they uphold their mission is to be proud
dalawang mamamahayag na subok sa tapang at talino.
To talk with all of you. Maraming salamat.
Magsasamahin ng isang agenda. Mondays to Fridays, 6 p.m. Only on BNC, the Bilyonario News Channel.
Welcome back. This is Weather HQ. Let's take a look at the global weather. Strong winds and heavy rains hit Cuba as Hurricane Rafael made landfall in the western part of the Caribbean island. More than 70,000 people have been evacuated in advance of Rafael's approach. President Miguel Díaz-Canel said the provinces of Artemisa, Havana, and Mayabec were worst hit. Rafael swept across the island in 2.5 hours before losing intensity as it entered the Gulf of Mexico. The Category 3 hurricane knocked out power in the island, still reeling from a recent blackout in a previous storm. Authorities were working to restore power to the center and east of the island and were assessing the damage to infrastructure in the west. Rafael is now in the Gulf of Mexico as a Category 1 hurricane and expected to weaken further in the coming hours. Over in California, USA, a wildfire fanned by hurricane-strength winds was burning out of control near Los Angeles on Wednesday, with thousands of residents ordered to evacuate and some taken to the hospital. Multiple large homes were destroyed as the fire tore through neighborhoods, blanketing a huge area in thick, choking smoke. Fierce gusts up to 130 kilometers an hour were fueling flames that were scorching through farmland. In Ventura County, the mountain fire had consumed more than 10,400 acres by Wednesday afternoon. In Malibu, Los Angeles County, the broad fire emerged Wednesday morning and quickly grew to 50 acres. By Wednesday afternoon, 15% of the broad fire had been contained. And that's Weather HQ for today. Join us again next week, only here on BNC, the Bilyonario News Channel. I'm Paolo De Rosario. Have a great weekend.